Welcome to Yuma Regional Medical Center. As you prepare for your joint replacement surgery, we would like to share with you what you need to know before your procedure. Your first step is to register and visit pre-admission testing. You'll need to bring the following items with you: your insurance card, your identification card, and a list of the prescription medicines you are currently taking, including over-the-counter vitamins, herbs, and other supplements. If you have the containers or bottles they came in, please bring those with you. If you have any recent medical records, please bring those along as well. Bring your implant, pacemaker, ICD defibrillator cards, your YRMC folder, your patient guide to total joint replacements, and information on your healthcare power of attorney or living will. We ask that you please arrive on time. You will enter the main entrance of the hospital and go directly to pre-admissions testing. A registered nurse will take your medical history and perform a physical exam. This may include a blood and urine test, an electrocardiogram or EKG, and a chest x-ray. You'll also receive information about several steps you'll need to take to help prevent infection, including how to use a surgical skin cleanser. It is very important that you follow these instructions carefully. You may be asked to contact your dentist to clear you for surgery to help prevent surgical complications from an oral infection. There are certain medicines you should not take in the days leading up to your surgery, including some pain relievers and certain prescription medicines. Do not stop taking any prescribed medicines without first talking to your doctor. If you have any questions about any of your medicines, call your doctor. Before surgery, you should get your house in order to get around safely when you return. Remove throw rugs, extension cords, or any items that will cause you to trip and fall, and use a non-slip bath mat. Making these home safety preparations in advance is very important. Everyone is different, and so is every discharge plan. After surgery, most patients spend a few days in the hospital and then go home. Occasionally, some patients go to a rehabilitation center for part of their recovery. Most physicians prefer that their patients go straight home, but several people will have input into your discharge plan, including you, your physician, therapist, case manager, and social worker. The night before your procedure, you may receive a phone call from our admission staff telling you what time to arrive at the hospital if there are any changes to your scheduled surgery. Otherwise, review your instructions as given by your pre-admissions testing nurse. You are welcome to call our pre-operation holding to verify your arrival time at 928-336-7135. If your surgery is scheduled for Monday, you will receive a phone call on Friday. When coming to the hospital, you may be asked to pack a small overnight bag with a couple of loose-fitting outfits and sneakers that are easy to put on and take off. When it is time, you will be prepped for the actual procedure. You will meet with your orthopedic team and review the details of your surgery so that you will know exactly what is going to happen and when. When everyone is ready, your procedure will begin. For your safety, you will verify your name and date of birth. The surgical site will be prepared and marked by the surgical team. Your family and friends can wait for you in the surgical waiting area. They should be prepared to wait for several hours while you are prepared for surgery, while you are in surgery, and while you are in the recovery room. After surgery, you will be brought to the recovery room. The orthopedic team will call your friends and family in the surgical waiting area and let them know how you are doing. Your recovery room nurse will take care of you. They will watch your vital signs, check your leg, and do whatever it takes to make you as comfortable as possible. While you are in the recovery room, you will get an x-ray of your new joint to take along to your room. You will then be brought to your hospital room. A nurse will give you a complete physical examination and will orient you to your room's features, such as the nurse call light and TV controls. After surgery, your diet will be pretty basic at first. You will have ice chips, clear liquids, broth, tea, juice, and gelatin, and will advance slowly as tolerated. Please tell the nurse if you have any nausea, as we have medications that can help. You will be allowed to start eating solid foods the morning after your surgery. Some pain is to be expected after your surgery, but we will do our best to make you as comfortable as possible. Pain medicine will be ordered for you by your doctors, so be sure to ask the nurse for pain medicine when you need it, especially as the effect of the spinal anesthesia wears off. Please do not wait for the pain to get bad before asking for pain medicine. It will help your recovery if you get out of bed as soon as possible. Getting out of bed also reduces your risk for blood clots. A few hours after your surgery, a physical therapist or nurse will get you out of bed, walk you down the hallway, and have you sit up in a chair. Wearing your compression boots is another way to reduce the risk of blood clots. While we want you to get back on your feet as soon as possible, your safety is most important. After surgery, you may be sleepy from the anesthesia and pain medicines, so please call for help when you need to get out of bed or out of a chair. Trying to get out of bed without help can delay your recovery and your discharge from the hospital. Remember, when getting out of bed or a chair or coming back from the bathroom, always ask for help. You will be taught how to use an incentive spirometer, which will help keep your lungs clear and active after surgery. Your specific discharge plan will be based on your doctor's recommendation and your physical therapist's evaluation. Our goal after surgery is for you to become independent enough to go home safely as soon as possible. We will arrange for you to receive any services needed to safely return home. The most important part of your recovery is activity. The goal of our therapy team is to help you become active and safely do things you need to do when you get home. The first move will be to get up and take your first steps on your new joint. Your physical therapist will help you with useful techniques and strengthening exercises and instruct you how to use a walker or crutches. You will even get to work out while lying down with exercises to do in bed, helping you become independent even faster. You will learn good ways to get in and out of bed, how to stand properly, good walking techniques, the best ways to sit and how to handle stairs, and of course you'll be reminded of not getting up without assistance. All of this will help you get stronger, faster, home sooner, and be safer around the house. You'll receive plenty of skilled guidance from your physical therapist and possibly an occupational therapist. Your physical therapist, or PT's goal is to get you up and around as soon as possible. With simple exercises, your physical therapist will help you increase your range of motion and muscle strength and will help you make steady progress. If recommended by your physician, your occupational therapist, or OT, will focus on helping you do everyday activities such as dressing and bathing. If you need it, your OT will give you specialized equipment to help you do these things more easily. So the occupational therapist will help you relearn how to do common tasks, and the physical therapist will help you get stronger with a range of exercises tailored to your needs. While you are in the hospital, you will continue to work with your rehab team to help you get stronger and continue with those daily life skills which are so important. Before you know it, you'll be ready to leave the hospital. When you are discharged, you will receive written instructions from your nurse or doctor to take with you. Instructions will cover things you need to do after you leave, such as monitoring your incision, stepping up your exercise program, and being aware of certain symptoms. There will also be additional PT and OT information for you and easy to follow instructions to help you recover and become more and more active. For more information about your total joint replacement experience, please see the patient guide to total joint replacement and call your physician's office. We thank you for choosing Yuma Regional Medical Center for your procedure, and we look forward to providing you excellent care.